Great and awesome is our Lord, our God, our Savior, and our King. Holy are you, Lord. Holy are you, Lord. All creation calls you God. You are awesome in this place. You are awesome in this place. You are worthy of all praise, Almighty God. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Blessed be the name of the Lord Most High. Great and faithful is our God. Mighty is our God. Mighty is our King. Hallelujah, hallelujah. We come just now to say thank you, O King. You're not just a part of our lives, but God, you are truly our everything. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Good morning, Holy Spirit of God, and welcome into our presence. Welcome into our day. Welcome into this time. Welcome into this fourth watch hour. Welcome onto all of these platforms. Holy Spirit, take full control. Cleanse, purify, sanctify every platform, the Arrows Internet Radio platform, sanctify the Instagram platform, sanctify the Facebook platform, sanctify the YouTube platform. Holy Spirit, let your will and your will only be done. Let your anointing fall afresh upon every person that has come to worship you this morning. Holy Spirit, take dominion. Take dominion in our space and our place, in our time and our season. Holy Spirit, make us living sacrifices, holy and acceptable unto the Lord Jesus Christ of Nazareth. Let the words of our mouths and the meditations of our hearts be acceptable in thy sight, O Lord, for thou art our strength and our redeemer. You are awesome in this place, Almighty God, and we give you all the praise, all the honor, and all the glory. Great are you, Lord. Great are you, Lord. You are great and greatly to be praised. Abba Father, you reign. Reign supreme. Reign sovereign. Reign, O wonderful, awesome God. Reign, O counselor and friend. Reign, O great and mighty God. Hallelujah to the King of Kings and Lord of Lords. Hallelujah to the Holy One of Israel. Jehovah is his name. Jehovah is his name. Good morning, good morning, good morning. Good morning, precious saints. Good morning, each and every one on this platform this morning of the fourth of the fourth watch. Hallelujah. It is truly an honor to serve with you, to worship with you, to sacrifice with you, to obey with you, to walk this journey with you, each and every one. Welcome this morning to Prophetic Wednesday. Hallelujah. We know that God has a word of encouragement, a word of healing, a word of deliverance for us this morning, because that's the kind of God he is. When he speaks to deliver, set free, and make whole. He speaks that we might have life and life more abundantly. He speaks that we might truly walk in the open doors under open heavens. He speaks that we might walk in the fullness of blessings that make rich and add no sorrow. And so as you come on to this platform this morning, I speak a blessing over your life. As you enter the holies of holies, I speak a blessing. I speak favor. I speak uncommon increase. I speak fresh anointing. I speak the precious, mighty, rushing wind of the Holy Spirit baptizing you afresh. I speak a cleansing. I speak a cleansing over you this morning as you come into this platform, as you come into this open heavens, as you come into this Kairos moment. I speak an uncommon blessing as you turn your radio, hallelujah, as you tune your channel to Arrows Internet Radio. I speak a blessing right through the system for which you are receiving this word. I speak a blessing over you. I speak a blessing over your life. I speak a blessing over your children, your marriage. I speak a blessing over your house, a blessing over the work of your hands, a blessing over your business, over your job. I speak a blessing over your health right now in the name of Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus, if I be your son, if I be a man of God, if I be your servant, if I be committed and submitted to you, if I be your chosen vessel, let a blessing fall upon your people right now in the mighty name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. Let a lifting and a shifting take place in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. Father God, by your spirit, I release the anointing for salvation in the houses of every person that is here in the homes, oh God. Anointing for salvation. Anointing for salvation. Salvation for children. Salvation for spouses. Salvation for aunts, uncles, cousins, nieces, and nephews. Salvation for parents, mom and dad. I release the anointing of salvation that your kingdom may come in every home, and your will be done on earth as it is in heaven. In the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, I prophesy salvation to the homes of God's people this morning, in the name of Jesus Christ. Wherever you are, whatever time zone, whether it's morning, afternoon, or night, I prophesy salvation, anointing into your house, a fresh move of the Spirit of God into your home, into your family, into your space, in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. I declare and decree that it is well in your house. I declare that your children that have seemingly gone wayward are beginning to shift. I speak a shift in your children's lives in the name of Jesus. I speak a shift in your spouse's life. Some of you are experiencing some difficulties in your marriage, and it seems as if it's going to end. It seems as if this is it, that divorce is imminent. I speak a shift even now, God Almighty. Those marriages that you have put together, if you are not the one separating, then God, I remove by prophetic decree every separation spirit from them, from marriages in this platform, marriages in the kingdom, in the name of Jesus. Lord, we come in agreement like the 120 in the upper room at Pentecost, and we say to you, Lord God Almighty, as they came down and met with the people, they came down in power, they came down in anointing, they came down in your glory. And so, God Almighty, we declare that it is your purpose, your will that must be done. And so I speak a shift. I speak a prophetic shift for salvation in the households of your people right now. Every unsaved husband, I command the move of the Spirit of the living God by the grace and mercy of the Lord Jesus Christ of Nazareth to come forth, to touch like you did Saul on Damascus Road. God, let every husband, let every wife experience an encounter, a divine encounter with you today, in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. Let a divine encounter move upon the people of God to bring salvation, to bring without hesitation a manifestation of your kingdom principle, of your kingdom needs, of your kingdom desires. Lord God Almighty, I speak the spirit of salvation in the homes of your people this morning, in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. Come on, receive it, receive it. If you have been declaring salvation for your children, for your spouse, for your mother and father, for your sisters and brothers, aunts, uncles, cousins, nieces and nephews, if you have been asking God to save your family members, right now is an open heaven for salvation. Right now is an open heaven for salvation. We have called upon the Lord and he has opened the heavens. Hey God, hey God, hey God. He has opened the heavens for salvation for your family members, salvation for your children, salvation for your son, for your daughter, salvation. Lord God Almighty, we are asking you this morning, for there is nothing more important to you than the souls of men. And so God Almighty, we ask you for household salvation this morning, for us, for me and my house, as for Lorna and her house, as for Laura and her house, as for Suzette, Peter and her house, as for Quenda Flores and her house, and all members of this family on Instagram, YouTube, Arrows Radio. Hallelujah. And as for us and our house, we will serve the Lord. Our house is our extended family. Hallelujah. We declare salvation this morning. The anointing for salvation will move through every corner and crevice. As for me and my house, as for Carol and her house, I declare salvation. Salvation to your husband. Salvation to your children. I speak the spirit of salvation upon each and every one of you right now in the name of Jesus Christ. Lord, let your will be done. Father, you went to great lengths to save Saul that he might become Paul. You went to great lengths to save, hallelujah, the jailer and his household. Oh God Almighty, you are no respecter of man. You caused Paul and Silas to be whipped, to be beaten, to be disrespected, and to be thrown in a deep dark dungeon, not because you just wanted to punish them, but because you wanted the soul of the jailer and his family. Lord God Almighty, what you have done before, we are asking you to do again. Do it now for the families of these your people gathered before you. Do it for my family, oh God. There are many in my bloodline that are alive but are not saved. They are alive but they are dead in the spirit. They are alive but they are walking zombies. I cancel the spirit of the zombie over my family. Come on, cancel the spirit of zombie over your family. They are walking dead. If they are not alive in Christ, they are walking dead. I know some of you might be offended by that language, but it is the absolute truth and nothing but the truth. So help you God. Hallelujah. And so we cancel the spirit of the walking dead from our family members, and we speak life and life more abundantly, because life only comes through Jesus Christ of Nazareth. Life can only be by his blood and his body. Life can only be by his spirit. Come on, somebody, come in agreement with me this morning and prophesy life to your family. Prophesy life to your family members. Prophesy life to your dead husband. Prophesy life to your dead children. I know you probably didn't think of it that way. God Almighty. But we cancel the spirit of death, spiritual death from our family members. I cancel by assignment. I cancel by authority. I cancel by power. Every assignment of death, every spirit of death, every spiritual death angel released against my family members. Come on, repeat it. I cancel by assignment every spirit of death released against my family members that will confuse them, that will destroy them, that will set them against the things of God. I cancel the spirit of darkness that has come against my family, that spirit that Jesus spoke about when he said light has come to the world, but men have chosen darkness rather than light. I cancel the spirit of darkness, K. White, off of your husband, off of your daughters, off of your sons, off of all of your children. Every spirit of darkness that desires to take your family, God Almighty, the devil says, you are already gone. You are already rooted and grounded in God, but I will take your family. I will take your family. We say and we declare and we prophesy this morning, the devil is a liar. He cannot take our families. We declare our children are saved. Our spouses are, exes are saved. Hallelujah. We declare that our mothers and fathers are saved. Our aunts, uncles, cousins, nieces, and nephews are saved. We prophesy this morning in the realm of the spirit, O God, for salvation is the most important thing that you died on Calvary's cross to release upon us. And so we declare righteousness, holiness, and truth in our bloodline right now in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. Lord God Almighty, I cut every member of this family loose this morning. I cut them loose from every plan, every scheme, and every trap of the enemy. Everything that has been imparted and inputted into the bodies, into the minds, into the souls of your people, I cancel it and uproot it this morning in the name of Jesus Christ. Every spiritual injection that you received last night, every medication that is in your body that has negative effects, side effects, that has a slow capsule-like effects to come to pass later, to cause cancer, to cause weak bladder, to cause heart failure, to cause any kind of deterioration of any organ in your body, any form of medication that you have ever taken, Hallelujah, hallelujah, that has some negative residual effect on your body later in life or currently. I cancel it by fire in the mighty name of Jesus. Those who are taking hypertension medication, those who are taking diabetic medication, those who are taking arthritis medication, those who are taking cancer medication, those who are taking COVID medications, hallelujah, I cancel every negative effect, every kickback spirit, every retroactive destructive spirit. I cancel you by assignment this morning in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. I declare that your task, your mission have been identified, have been discovered, have been unveiled, and I prophesy that your work is destroyed. Your work is destroyed now in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. Every family destroying spirit, every family separating spirit, separating mothers from daughters, separating sons from fathers, separating the husband from the wife, I uproot you this morning, you family destroying spirit, you family destroying spirit, I uproot you in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. Every child that is telling their parents, I don't want to be here, I want to move out, I want to go do something else, I want to go live somewhere else, every family that is every parent that are as estranged, and the mother is keeping the children or the child from the father, or the father is keeping the child from the mother, I uproot that separating spirit, I uproot that Jezebel spirit from the families of God's people now in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. Every spirit of slumber, every spirit of slothfulness, every spirit of depression and distress as a result of losing a loved one, I command you to lift from God's people this morning in the name of Jesus Christ. Whether that loved one has left the relationship, or that loved one has passed away, or that loved one has gone off to a far place, the relationship is still intact, but they are so far that it causes pain and distress. Hallelujah, hallelujah, I uproot every pain and every distress spirit that has come against you in the name of Jesus Christ. I uproot by fire, I uproot by fire, I uproot by fire every wicked spirit operating against your life this morning. I command by the authority of the Lord Jesus Christ of Nazareth, every spirit working against you at the sound of my voice, I order every unclean spirit, every spirit of infirmity, every demonic spirit at the sound of my voice, loose God's people right now. If your ears are hearing my voice, then the demons are hearing me. Our demonic forces operating in your house, I command you now, you're operating around God's people, I command you now, spirit of hypertension, spirit of diabetes, spirit of unforgiveness, spirit of distress, spirit of pain and agony, spirit of hurt, spirit, unclean spirits, I command you right now, uproot, 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 uproot from God's people, uproot now in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. Spirit of regret, come on, spirit of regret, every spirit that have come through a portal of witchcraft into the homes and into the lives of God's people, at the sound of my voice, I order you, find back your place. Find your place in the dry, dark places. Find your place in the marine kingdom. Find your place in the pit of hell. I don't care where you go, but I order you right now, be uprooted from God's people now, now, now. Every spirit of lust, every spirit of lust, hallelujah, every secret spirit, every secret moving spirit that is designed to keep secrets in marriages, to keep secrets in families, there is no transparency, I uproot you now, I uproot you now in the name of Jesus Christ. Every time capsule spirit waiting to arise later in the lives of God's people, in the lives of our children, I uproot you by fire this morning in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, and I declare you insufficient for operation in our lives in the name of Jesus. I declare that our lives belong to the Holy Spirit. Holy Spirit of God, you are the only one that is supposed to operate in us and through us. And so, Holy Spirit, you are welcomed here. Come flood our lives and fill the atmosphere. For your glory, O Lord, is what our hearts long for, to be overcome by your presence. Holy Spirit, take dominion in our homes. Take dominion in our space, wherever we are, wherever your people are this morning. Holy Spirit, at work, at the gym, at the jogging track, at walking track. Hallelujah. In transit, on the traffic, in the bus, in the train, wherever your people are this morning, Holy God of Israel, Lord Jesus Christ of Nazareth, Holy Spirit, hallelujah, I ask you to minister to your people right now. Minister to your people and lift, deliver, set free, and make whole in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. Let no weapon form against your people prosper. Let every tongue that rise against us in judgment be condemned and destroyed by fire right now in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. Every unclean spirit working against you at your job or at your company that you own, I uproot every unclean spirit, every demonic force working to dislodge you, working to shut down your business, working to cause you to lose your job, working to make you uncomfortable in your workspace. I shut that spirit down now in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. Lord God Almighty, by the same spirit that worked through Elijah when he said, as of now, it will not rain for 3 years. Oh God Almighty, by the same spirit that worked in Elijah, that said, hallelujah, by this time next year, you will have a son. By that same Holy Spirit that raised Christ Jesus from the dead, by that same Holy Spirit that caused fire to come down upon the soldiers who came to get Elijah, by that same spirit, hallelujah, that parted the Jordan on the way to the place of his rapture. Ah, God. God, by the same spirit that worked for Elisha when he got the mantle and said, where is the God of Elijah? By the same spirit that parted the Red Sea for Moses and the Jordan River for Joshua, by that same spirit I command every unclean spirit working against your business, working against you at your job, working to disrupt, delay, derail, or deny you from the fulfillment of your purpose, I uproot that spirit by fire in the mighty name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. Come on, join with me and uproot that Jezebel from your company. Come on, uproot that spirit of discord, uproot that spirit from your church. Come on, if you work at a church and there are some things happening that you're saying, how could this be happening at a church? How could this be happening at my office? How could this be happening in my space? Uproot now, uproot this morning, every Absalom spirit, uproot every Jezebel spirit, uproot every Ahab spirit, uproot in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. I declare that we shall not be fired, or we shall not have to resign. We shall be promoted, elevated, given salary increase. Our businesses shall expand and increase. We are, after all, the children of the Most High God. And so, Lord God Almighty, I prophesy to your people this morning. I prophesy to their businesses. I prophesy to their jobs. I prophesy, thus saith the Lord, you shall flourish. Thus saith the Lord, you shall receive double for your trouble. Thus saith the Lord, you shall receive everything that was stolen from your fathers and from your mothers and from your great, 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 great grandparents. I declare, thus saith the Lord, restoration is coming. Restoration has come. Restoration is here, and restoration shall continue. The year of God's favor has begun, and it shall be so in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. I uproot every blockading spirit, every spirit that is blocking you from purpose, blocking you from receiving your documents, blocking you from receiving your salary increase, blocking you from receiving your promotion, blocking you from receiving God's favor. I uproot every blockading spirit now in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, and I declare that they shall create new opportunities for you. They shall create new opportunities for you to do want to be. Opportunities shall be created in your church for you. In the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, I declare promotion, a spirit of promotion. Promotion in the spirit and promotion in the natural. Come on, in the mighty name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, I am releasing the spirit of excellence upon each and every one of us under the sound of my voice this morning. Whether you're on radio, on Instagram, on Facebook, or on YouTube, I'm releasing the spirit of excellence, for the spirit of the Lord is upon us, and he is the spirit of excellence. The spirit of the Lord is upon us, and he is the spirit of eloquence. The spirit of the Lord is upon us, and he is the spirit of strength, the spirit of power, love, and a sound mind, the spirit of greatness, the spirit of uncommon favor. And so I release the spirit of excellence upon you this morning. I release the spirit of wisdom and understanding upon you this morning. Come on, receive the spirit of wisdom and understanding. Receive it. Come on, all you got to say is, I receive it. I receive it. And the Lord is pouring out uncommon measures of the spirit of wisdom and understanding, of the spirit of counsel and might, as the spirit of knowledge and of the fear of the Lord. The Lord said to Solomon that there shall be none wiser, but he never said that there wouldn't be any as wise. I release the wisdom of Solomon. I release the spirit of wisdom and understanding that was upon Solomon, upon each and every one of you under the sound of my voice. Receive it in the name of Jesus. Your wisdom shall be evident as of today. Come on, in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. Come on, hallelujah. Marie Thomas, I uproot everything that is going on at that workplace. I uproot it by fire. I uproot it by fire. I know that you would want to leave there because of how distressing and how the situation is uncomfortable. But God says you first must be comfortable in an uncomfortable environment before you can move to the next level. That next level might be a promotion at that same place, or it might be a promotion out of that place. But at your first, your system that is disrupted, your system that is uncomfortable, I know the spirit of the Lord is saying to me, Sister Marie Thomas, that you despise going to work. When you wake up in the morning, whether you have to go online or in person, you're stressing. You're saying, I don't want to go face them. I don't know what they're gonna do to me today. I don't know what they're gonna say about me. I don't know, but I don't want to go. I don't want to go. But the spirit of the Lord is saying, my peace I have given unto you, not a spirit of fear I have given you, but a spirit of power and love and of a sound mind. And so we walk in the spirit of power in the name of Jesus. Ah, God Almighty, there are so many of us that are doing things, that are operating businesses, that has been fledgling, that has been seeming like it is not going anywhere, and we just don't even want to go anymore. We don't want to do it. We're saying, God, what has happened? I've been praying and my business is not growing. It is just barely getting by. It is even taking more out of me than it's supposed to. Ah, God Almighty, and my job is the same thing. But this morning, God, I prophesy as your son. I prophesy as your servant. I prophesy as your anointed one. One who you have called, not because I am perfect, but you have called me because there's a job to be done. And so, Lord God Almighty, if I be your son, let a shift take place this morning in the lives, in the businesses, in the jobs, in the workplace of your people. In the name of Jesus, let promotions come into play, God Almighty, while they are cutting back and reducing staff. Let your people be promoted while they are looking, oh God Almighty, to reduce salary expenses. Let your child and children be promoted and increase in finances. In the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, Lord, while they are cutting back on perks, let your daughter, your son, get a company car. In the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, allowances, oh God Almighty, be released in the name of Jesus. Oh God Almighty, while the enemy is trying to make more and more people sick, I come against that spirit of sickness. I come against the spirit of Omicron in the name of Jesus, that unclean spirit called Omicron. I come against you this morning. I bind you this morning. We come in agreement this morning and we declare that you shall not overtake America. There are some people looking on from the outside and talking about America deserve what them get because they have been going as if they have a wonder drug, a magic drug, and they must pay the price like COVID not keeping because their stadiums are full and they're not wearing any mask. Their arenas are full. Their people are going about in restaurants and all these things. Persons from all over the world are looking on, but that's not God's heart. That's not God's heart. They're just trying to live, to return to normal, return to the life that they know and they want to enjoy. And whether they know Jesus yet or not, God takes no delight in the punishing of the wicked, in the death of the wicked, until that good and faithful day comes. And so our job is to intercede. And so Lord God Almighty, as leader of this family, as leader of this group, I come in agreement with every member of this family, and I come against the Omicron spirit. I come against that Omicron spirit, that COVID-19 spirit with the variant Omicron. I come against you now. I bind you over the United States. I bind you over Jamaica. I bind you over England. I bind you over Canada. I bind you over Africa. I bind you over the Middle East. I bind you over all of Asia. I bind you, your spirit of Omicron. I bind you from South America. I bind you from all of the Caribbean. I bind you from all of Europe in the name of Jesus Christ. We as the children of God come against you in agreement. We come in one accord and we say, Omicron, you must go in the mighty name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. We command you in the name of Jesus. We bind your legs. We bind your hands. We bind your neck. And we cut off your head like David cut off Goliath's head. And we say, die, Omicron, die. Die, Omicron, die. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, go from this place and be gone. In the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. Father, we speak to every person right now that is carrying the virus, hallelujah, that is carrying that virus in their lungs, in their throat, in their ear, nose, hallelujah. Oh, God Almighty, wherever that virus has taken up residence, even in Patricia's son, we command an uproot, oh God Almighty, and we declare this morning that every person that we know, even if they're not listening right now, once we know them and everyone even that we don't know that are in the hospitals that are sick with this disease, with this virus, we command an uproot right now from their lungs. We declare today is the day of miracle and that they shall hear of miraculous restorations. We declare that miraculous restorations, hallelujah, shall be delivered upon God's people. Miss Fraser, I command you to be made whole now. Every COVID-19 symptoms, go now. Patricia's son, every COVID-19 symptom, go now. In the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, I take the PCR test right now in the spirit and I declare you healed. I declare you delivered. I declare you set free and made whole in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. Hallelujah. And Father, as you heal, as you deliver, as you set us free, as you make us whole, we pray for our nations, oh God. We pray for the nations of the world. We pray, oh God Almighty, for the governments, the presidents and prime ministers and premiers, oh God Almighty, and all the members of the cabinets that are running these various nations. Father, you see and know, you are the one that is in the secret places. God Almighty, Ezekiel would never have known that there were some priests in the temple worshiping the sun god unless you took him from the place where he was and take him to the temple and showed him through the very walls what was going on. God Almighty, we do not know the magnitude of evil plans that the enemy has put in place, that has set in train against your people in these walls, oh God Almighty, among these leaders. But Father, you know, and if you know, then it is okay. If you know, then we know that you who love justice, you who love justice, you who hate injustice, you who hate robbery, you who hate iniquity, oh God Almighty, will come to our rescue and deliver us. Ah, God Almighty, uproot. We speak and uproot from every evil that has been planted in our governments, in our various nations, in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. Lord, every nation that is represented on these platforms, O God Almighty, we speak into them now as the atmosphere is receiving my voice. May every element and aspect of evil that exists within these nations be gone right now in the name of Jesus. I speak governmental shift, governmental changes, governmental attitude. I'll shift, Lord God Almighty, as you shift the attitude and the heart of Pharaoh by the things he saw, as you shift the heart of Abimelech by the conversation you had with him. So I pray, God Almighty, that whatever means and whatever modality that is necessary, that you will use it against the various governments of the world, that they might know, that they might see, that they might recognize that you are God all by yourself, in the mighty name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. Do a work in their hearts, O God Almighty. Shift, O God, because the heart of the king belongs to you. It is in your hand, and you can turn it however way you choose. And so, God Almighty, these sinister plots, these plans, O God Almighty, to do harm to the people that you have created. God, man cannot create man, but man have chosen to seek to destroy man. I cancel that assignment. I cancel every governmental systems, every governmental agencies that have been tasked to reduce the population. God Almighty, may they meet you face to face, not as the lamb, but as the lion. May the lion of the tribe of Judah roar in the various houses of parliament. May the lion of the tribe of Judah roar in the president's office of China, of the United States, of England, and of all these power broker G8. God Almighty, may they experience your face as the lion, and may they tremble in their boots and turn from their evil ways in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. Lord, we pray this morning for the nation of Israel. We pray, O God Almighty, that peace will come to Israel. Peace will come to Jerusalem. God Almighty, you said you will bless those who bless Israel, and you will curse those who curse them. We as a family declare and decree that Israel is blessed, that Jerusalem has peace in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. Hallelujah. We declare salvation for the Jews. Every Jew, O God Almighty, that day shall come, even as you gather the Gentiles in great numbers. I declare, God, that you will gather the Jewish people in great numbers in the mighty name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. They shall come to recognize and accept that the Messiah, Yeshua the Mashiach of Nazareth, hallelujah, was born, and he lived and died and rose again, and has ascended into heaven, and has been given a name that is above every name, that he will come again. But he has sent his Holy Spirit, the Comforter, the God of truth, that lives in us and lives for us and lives through us, in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. And so we thank you this morning, O God Almighty, for salvation for the Jewish people, even as you declare salvation for us and our house, in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. Thank you, O great and sovereign God, for your good hand upon each and every one of us. Thank you for the shift that has taken place in our lives and in our systems, in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. And we give you praise and honor and glory in Jesus Christ of Nazareth's name. Amen and amen. Hallelujah. Give God a praise. Give God a praise. Give God a praise. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Give the Lord a praise this morning. Hallelujah, 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 hallelujah. Madugal, how are you feeling, my sister? How are you feeling? Hallelujah. Sandra Graham, my Graham, how are you feeling? Hallelujah. I sense that the enemy is trying to attack your system, trying to attack your system. Madugal and Sandra Graham. Hallelujah. I speak to those two women of God's body right now. I speak to your bodies right now, Sandra. Hallelujah. My Graham and my Dougal, I speak to your bodies right now. I speak to you, Andrea. I speak to your soul right now. I speak to your soul, and I said, your soul, hallelujah, the enemy is trying to downcast you. He's causing you to be reminiscing, going back into Even your memory is trying to convince you that there are some things that you could have done differently, some mistakes that you have made that has led to the news that you have heard just this day. But let not the enemy enter your mind at all. Let not the enemy enter your mind. Your mind, your soul, your will, and your emotion, hallelujah, belongs to the Lord Jesus Christ of Nazareth. And so I cancel every negative suggestion that you are sick. I cancel every negative suggestion that you are depressed. I cancel every negative suggestion that you are not who God says you are. And I declare prophetically this morning that you are the head and not the tail, no matter what you see or experience. You are rich and not poor, no matter what you see, in the name of Jesus. You are healthy and not sick, no matter what you feel, in the mighty name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. I speak strength to you even now, even now, even now. Strength, the strength of the Holy Spirit. Arise in every person under the sound of my voice. Holy Spirit, arise with strength. Arise to refresh. Arise to rejuvenate. Arise to repair and restore. Arise, Holy Spirit, with revival in the lives of your people, in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. Hallelujah, 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 hallelujah. On Sunday, the Lord asked me to reveal, to release the spirit of the just do it. Hallelujah. I release the spirit of the just do it upon each of you this morning. Just do it. Just declare. Just decree. Just prophesy. Just do it. Just do it. Just do it. Do not have what you need and not need what you have. You need what you have, therefore you must use what you have to the best advantage of yourself and of your family. Hallelujah. So speak peace over your circumstance. Speak mountains be removed. Speak Red Sea part. Speak Jordan River part. Speak, hallelujah, wall of Jericho come down. Come on, God says we are to do it. And so I prophesy to your soul this morning. I prophesy to your spirits this morning. And I declare that everything that has blocked you from coming into the fullness of your purpose, coming into the fullness of what is rightfully yours, I command them to loose now in the name of Jesus Christ. The only thing that should be held up for you is that which God himself has held up. And so I release tax returns that have been held up by the whole by demonic forces. I release papers that have been held up by demonic forces. Come on, in the name of Jesus Christ. I release immigration documents that have been held up, hallelujah, by demonic forces. I release, hallelujah, your children's documentations. I release every paper, every document that has been in the system that Satan has sought to hold up. I release them now in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. I release your house papers, your new car papers, in the mighty name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. I release you into the fullness of God's favor today. I prophesy God's favor. I prophesy God suddenly. I prophesy God's Shekinah glory upon each and every one of you to walk in the fullness of the just do it anointing, in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. Come on, hallelujah, hallelujah. You have to be interested. You have to be excited about the just do it anointing. Hallelujah. You have to tap into the spirit and know that God wants you to just do it. God wants you to speak to your office before you get there. God wants you to speak to your marriage. Don't speak to your husband. Don't speak to your wife. Speak to the spirit. Come on, hallelujah. Stop arguing. Stop disagreeing. Stop confronting and talking about, I have to speak the truth. I have to confront. No, you have to bind the strong man first before you can make any headway. Come on, glory to God. Jesus says, can a thief enter a man's house without first binding? Come on, you got to bind the strong man that is in your house, operating against your children, operating against your marriage, operating against your prosperity and good success. Hallelujah. You got to bind that strong man that is holding back your husband from coming into your life, holding back your wife from coming into your life, in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. Come on, you single women, you got to bind that strong man. Come on, you've been asking God, where is my husband? I need to get married. I need a husband. And God says, you have not found the strong man. I prophesy to the strong man working against your marriage this morning. Hallelujah. And I command that strong man that is in the minds of some, in the souls of some, in the spirit of some, in the mind, will, and emotion of some. I bind that strong man this morning with chains and ropes and cords. Ah, God Almighty, and fetters. I bind that strong man this morning, and I release you to have the mind of Christ. I release you to flow in the glow and the glory of the Lord Jesus Christ of Nazareth. I release you to be married in 2022 in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. Every hindrance, every blockage that has been blocking you from getting married, or blocking your marriage from being demonstrating the grace of a great marriage, I release that blockage. I destroy that blockage. I blow up that blockage this morning, and I release your husband. I release your wife. I release the restoration and repairing of your marriage. And I also release upon you repatriation. For as long as you have been in abeyance, as long as you have been stagnant, as long as you have been fighting with the battle, hallelujah, and I've lost precious time, I put a value on your time this morning. I put a value on your pain. I put a value on your discomfort. I put a value this morning, and I command Lucifer and his demons to pay you in the name of Jesus Christ for the distress and discomfort and delay that he has caused in your life, in your marriage, and in your singleness, in the name of Jesus. Those who have lost spouses, I release you, oh God Almighty, to receive from God repairing of your heart and restoration of your joy in a new spouse, in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. Thank you, Lord, for your blessing upon your people. Thank you, Lord, for your peace that passeth all understanding. Thank you, Lord, for your love towards your people, in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Come on, grab your husbands, grab your wives, grab your breakthrough. Hallelujah, grab your breakthrough, grab your breakthrough, grab your healing. Come on, grab your healing. Hallelujah. Some of you have been sick for years, been on medication for years. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. We declare, come on, hallelujah, we declare healing, and we declare restoration. Hallelujah. We declare that no poison, no toxins in our bodies shall cause untimely death, shall cause any organ shutdown or any organ failure. We command healing to our bodies now. Perfect circulation, perfect blood platelet and blood counts in the mighty name of Jesus. Our joints and marrow, hallelujah, our very DNA is blessed, is healthy and whole in the mighty name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. We declare every sinus issue, every sinus disorder, gone now in the mighty name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. Every draining in our throat and onto our lungs, we command and uproot right now. Every spirit of sinusitis draining into our systems, I block you, I bind you, and I command you out now in the mighty name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. Loose God's people right now. Spirit of cancer, loose now in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. Every spirit of sexual immorality, every sexual immoral spirit, every sexual deviant spirit, I call you by name this morning, and I uproot you from God's people. At the sound of my voice, every deviant spirit operating through lust, through pornography, come on, through masturbation, and through any other sexual deviance, I uproot you now, uproot now, uproot now, uproot now, and I command you, go from God's people and from their family, from their children, in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. Yes, that's it. The scissors of the spirit cut the umbilical cord that connects any of our family, our children, our children's children, our aunts, uncles, cousins, nieces, and nephews, any member of our bloodline connected to sexual immorality, connected to warped and unclean, uncommon behavior. According to Romans 1, we will not agree. We cut off that cord. We sever that connection, and we command a restoration in the name of Jesus Christ. According to the will and purpose of God, we will not embrace or or agree with anything that is not of God. We cancel that assignment and we declare not in our house, not in our cabinet, in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. We are not preaching hate. We're not against anyone. We're against Satan's work. In the mighty name of Jesus, we love people. We hate sin. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. And so we will always come against sin. We will always send fire against sin and everything that has to do with sin. And we declare that it is well in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. Loose God's people right now. Loose God's people right now. Satan, you are a liar and you have no part or lot with God's people in Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. Hallelujah. What a time of prayer. Give the Lord a praise. Give the Lord a praise. Give the Lord a praise. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. In all of his ways, he deserves all praise. Hallelujah is the highest praise. I know some of you are beginning to feel a shift in your atmosphere. There was a spirit of heaviness in some of your spaces where you were this morning. A lot of persons didn't feel like getting up since the Christmas holidays. So many things have happened. And so persons are struggling to arise this early in the morning, are struggling to get into the mindset. But this is the time, as one of my favorite apostle Joshua Selman says, when we go to pray, when we go to devotion, when we go to do the things of God. Hallelujah, 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 hallelujah. Honey, my wife, glory to God, glory to God. Hallelujah. I'm hearing something. Yeah, praise God. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Yes, Lord. And so, hallelujah. He says there are times when we will go through issues. We will go through situations. We will go through circumstances and we'll feel like we can't. We'll feel like we can't press. When someone dies, when a relationship breaks up, when we get fired from a job or we quit a job with thinking that God wants us to do something else, and we're in that window. We're seeming to be going through the valley of the shadow of death, and we are fearing the evil that is on the other side, the evil of the unknown. We're fearing that which we do not understand, and God is saying to us in this season, be of great comfort, be comforted, because I am your God and I am with you. I will never leave you or forsake you in the mighty name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. Be of peace, be of joy in the name of Jesus. Regardless of what you're going through, the Lord says, be in peace, for I am your God in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. What a mighty God we serve. Angels bow before him. Heaven and earth adore him. What a mighty God we serve. So be encouraged, people of God, because as you give praise, as you press through the things that you feel like you can't press through. My sister Andrea has lost her a very dear person in her life, a person she spent many years with. Hallelujah. And had some good times. Yes, once you get with human beings, there'll be bad times as well, but there were good times as well. And when someone passes, you remember the good times more than the bad times. That's why you feel a little sad. But God says he is your comfort. He is your comfort. Woman of God, be encouraged. God is your comforter. And do not let the enemy plant any seed of negativity in your mind. Stay strong. And when the thoughts come, hallelujah. And I'm saying this not just in the face of death or the breaking up of relationship, but the severing of anything. Sometimes God will cut us loose from some things. He says those who he loves, he chastens. And chastening feels like punishment at the time. But chastening is not punishment. Chastening is preparation. Come on, glory to God. When we go through difficulties, when things are not the way we expect them or would like them to be, excuse me, hallelujah, it is not that we are being punished. It is that we are being prepared. If we change our perspective when we are going through, when the enemy starts to attack us, hallelujah, from Sunday morning of this week, my household have just been experiencing different encounters with the enemy, but we stand strong believing that Jesus Christ is Lord. Yesterday, hallelujah, a problem that I thought was solved, fixed, hallelujah, from Sunday when I went to drive out yesterday, my car wouldn't start after I bought a brand new battery and put in. And when my next door neighbor started to help me and started to fix and do some stuff, things just kept not falling into place. Things, every time he did something, he had to undo it. Every time he fixed something, it fell apart again. And the unsaved man turned and looked at me and says, "Boy, the devil will fight you bad." I laughed and I said, "Yes, that's a good thing." I laughed. I don't know if he understood, but I laughed and I said, "Man, my brother, anytime you're working for a child of God, hear me, people of God. Hear me, people of God. Unless we can be encouraged in the midst of a situation that other people would be depressed by, unless we can worship in a situation or a circumstance that other people would be depressed and sad and downcast and upset by, then we have not yet understood the battle that we are in. We have not yet understood that we are called to be a part of the 300 of Gideon, not the 32,000 of the opposing army. Amen. We are called to be like those in the 300. We are called to be like those in the 120 of the upper room at Pentecost. And there must be one accord in peace, one accord in joy, one accord in hope, one accord in confidence. We are like Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego, that no matter what happens, no matter what threats come, no matter what fire we are going to face, we will not bow. We will not relent. We will believe that Jesus Christ is our deliverer. Right to our last breath, we will be confident that Jesus Christ of Nazareth is our deliverer. He is our present help in times of trouble. He will not put us to shame. Amen. Praise God. Hallelujah. So be encouraged, each and every one of you, regardless of what you're going through in this season. I'm not saying that you're not to feel the hurt of the disappointment. You're not to feel that, you know, this is not what you wanted and this is not what you should be going through. Every one of us feel the pain of our circumstances, but the pain of our circumstances does not dictate how we act or respond. Amen. So that's all I'm saying. Cry if you must. Talk to someone if you must. Admit that you are hurting if you must. Come on. I'm not trying to live a lie. We are human beings. You've seen me cry. I'm not ashamed of my emotion. I'm not ashamed of the fact that I feel pain, discomfort. I'm not ashamed of the things that I go through, because it's part of living in this world. Where I would need to be ashamed if the things I go through dictated how I respond, dictated who I am, changed my peace, took away my joy, caused me to be cursing God like Job's wife wanted Job to do, to curse God and die. No, we shall not die but live to declare the works of the Lord. And so I encourage each and every one of you under the sound of my voice this morning. You will go through some stuff. You will lose loved ones. You will have broken relationships. You will get fight against and even fired from jobs. Your business will go down. Your life will seem like it is not going the way you want it to. You will face some ailments and some sicknesses. You will have some problems with your children. But guess what? If you stand in peace and remember, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil, for my God is with me. When I cannot walk anymore, he will carry me. When the enemy comes against me like a flood, my God will raise up a standard against him. When I look to my Jesus, I will be radiant and my face will never be covered with shame. Your child will not go to prison. Your daughter will not become a prostitute. Your children will not be victims of sex trafficking or slave trade. You shall not be put to shame in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. If your business is down now, it will come up again, because he who has begun a good work is faithful, in the name of Jesus Christ. Come on. You might be the ragtag reject at your office now, when you once used to be the dream boy or the dream girl. Well, it will happen again, but in a greater measure. Come on. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. So be encouraged. Be encouraged. Be encouraged. Hallelujah. Sister V, I heard that yesterday your son, hallelujah, was having some issues, blood platelet low and all kinds of things. Father, we declare this morning that Sister V, her son is well. Her son is well. I speak to him wherever he is now. I speak to his blood. I speak to his mind, will, and emotion. And I command a restoration right now. I prophesy to his blood. I prophesy to his DNA. I prophesy to his generation. And I cut him loose from every generational curse right now. Come on, grab it, people of God. Grab it. Every generational curse that leads to sickness and disease that has come down through your generation, I cancel it by fire. I cancel it by fire. I release you into generational blessings. Generational blessings must come from us. Our children must give God thanks for us, because we are the source of generational blessings, in the name of Jesus. We will leave an inheritance for our children and our children's children, in the name of Jesus. My mother will not die before she'll smile at the inheritance that she leaves for me and for her grandchildren, in the name of Jesus. Amen. Hallelujah. My aunts, uncles, cousins, nieces, and nephews will not die before they leave an inheritance for their children and their children's children, as long as the Lord tarries. Come on, declare it this morning. I will not die, but live to declare the works of the Lord. Amen. My children and my children's children, come on, I speak to Nathaniel. Nathaniel must prosper, must live, must be restored, must be redeemed, because one of the blessings that make rich and add no sorrow, one of the blessings that we leave, or the inheritance that we leave for our children, is the inheritance of the body and the blood of Yeshua, the Mashiach of Nazareth. And therefore, healing is Nathaniel's purpose and process, in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. We will not die and leave our generation, our children, our community, and our nation the same way we saw it. We will not die. I prophesy, we will not die and leave our environment the same way we came and saw it. Whatever it is that our parents and grandparents handed to us, we throw that into the river. We throw that into the sea. We give that to the marine kingdom, and we say, Lord, start us afresh. Give us your glory in our hands. Give us your mind in our minds. Give us your heart in our heart. Give us your access, O God Almighty, to great and mighty things, that we might leave a legacy of faith, a legacy of hope, a legacy of peace, a legacy of joy, a legacy of confidence in who you are. May that which was upon David when he went before the lion and the bear and Goliath be upon every person under the sound of my voice now, in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. May we go through trials and tribulations like you did, Lord Jesus, and like Paul did after you. Hallelujah. If they boil us in spiritual oil like they did John, God, may we come out unscathed. Hallelujah. May the enemies of our soul, hallelujah, be our footstool in this year, in Jesus' name. Amen and amen. Hallelujah. Praise God. Praise God. I wanted to stop praying about 15 minutes ago, and God just kept putting new things on my heart. New things, new things, new things, for prophetic declaration. on this day. And so there must have been something that each person that is on this morning could grab a hold of and run with in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. Remember, we are the prophets of our own lives. You guys have to begin to prophesy to your situations, your circumstances. Come on, Madugal, prophesy to your health, prophesy to your children. Suzette, prophesy. Come on, Suzette, you got to lay hands on the pillow. You know what I'm talking about. Lay hands on the pillow where heads put. Put olive oil on your hand, not too much that it is shown. Put some olive oil on your hand. Hold your hand up to heaven. Come on, women, hear me. If your husbands are unsaved, or if your husbands are saved but they're not operating in their priestly position or in their kingly position, put some olive oil on your hand today, today, today. Put some olive oil on your hand. Make sure that it has not, don't listen now. Don't bother with the religious thing where you dab your hand with oil as if you're going to anoint somebody to take an office. No. Stealth. Come on. Stealth. Secret. Come on. We're going in covert and we're changing our atmosphere. Amen. So women, ladies, put some olive oil on your hand. And I mean single ladies as well. Come on, we're doing a prophetic act this morning. Come on, Denise, put some olive oil on your hand. Hold your hand up to the Lord and say, Lord, let these hands be the hands that draw, hallelujah, my future husband to me now. I am putting my hand on this pillow in prophetic obedience that my husband shall be sleeping beside me in 2022 in the name of Jesus. Come on, Denise. Come on, do it, girl. Come on, Althea. You need that husband if you want him. Come on, obey the prophetic decree this morning. Come on, glory to God. If you have a husband and him not as how you would want him to be, things are doing good, but it's not as tight, not as fiery as it used to be. Come on, glory to God. You want some more fire? You feel you should be getting fixed up 3 times a week, but you're only getting fixed up once a month or once every 3 months. Come on, put some oil on your hand, put it on that pillow and say, Lord, may my husband get his vim, vigor and vitality again. May he begin to fix up till I have to cry cree, till I have to ask for mercy. Come on, glory to God. It matters not what it is. It sounds like I'm joking, but I'm so serious. Come on, put some oil on your hand and put it on that pillow, and whatever it is you want to be in that bed with you, that's what must be there. Come on, a mighty man of valor, a man of God, a man who loves God more than life itself, a man who honors you, a man who loves you down to the very ground you walk on, a man who will be a king to provide, to protect and to keep, a man who will be a priest to war, to stand on the wall, to see in the realm of the spirit and to know. Come on, you got to know what you want from a man in the name of Jesus Christ. And so if you have a husband and he's unsaved, put your hand on that pillow and say, God, when his head touch this pillow again, may it be like a Damascus Road encounter. May he come to the fullness of the glory of this encounter, and may he never look back. God, may I be jealous of him as he grows in the spirit, as he floats in the atmosphere of glory. God, may I have to be looking up and, like Sarah, call my man Lord in the name of Jesus. God, may we lay on our backs looking in the ceiling and saying, what a good God. Only he could bring such joy, such peace, such pleasure in the name of Jesus Christ. Pleasure without measure is your treasure in the name of Jesus. But you got to just do it. You got to just do it. So just do it this morning, ladies. Hallelujah. I don't care what age or stage your husband is in. Come on, woman of God. God is a miraculous God. If your husband has not sparked or jumped or tickled in a long time, put your hand on that pillow and say, God, it's been a long time. Come on, God, rise up and wise up. Come on, I need the prize up. Hey, glory to God. And he will do it. Come on, it sounds like I'm joking, but I'm serious. In the name of Jesus Christ. If you have been separated, your husband is gone north and you are south, and you want that marriage to come back and to work, put your hand on that pillow and command him according to the will and purpose of God to return to that matrimonial bed, and don't carry no baggage when him coming back. No Jezebel spirit. Come on. Hallelujah. must come with him. When he's coming, he must come back clean, washed and cleansed. When Pharaoh sent for Joseph, and I close with this and this part, and then we're going to go into some word. When Pharaoh sent for Joseph, he didn't allow Joseph to enter the palace with any of what was on him in prison. Come on, people of God. Only what was in him could come into Pharaoh's palace. Nothing that was on him. Pharaoh made him take a shower. They bathed him. The stench, the smell, the look, everything. He gave him new clothes. Everything that represented on the outside of him had to go. And so he couldn't come with any connection to the prison. Your husband must not come with any connection to the world, any connection to Satan. It must be washed off as you call him forth in the name of Jesus. Amen. You get the principle? You following me? Praise God. You ready, Laura? Jesus. Hallelujah. And as I said, even if your husband is doing well, he can still do better. If he's doing good, he can still do great. Come on. My wife gone inside the room right now. My wife gone inside the room right now. She just come back out with this. She beat all the pillow. Glory to God. Yes, Lord. Up the ante, God. More, God. More. There is always more. God has so much in store for us, guys. We must not be bashful or shy to want more. We got to just believe and we will receive. Amen. Praise God. Hallelujah. Yes, it's true. You know, she just come back out. Praise God. Don't laugh at me. I want to be better too. I'm thanking God that she believed by faith and lay hands on the pillow. Yes. I hope she called forth some great things. Hallelujah. Some people are on their back laughing, but it's true. Come on, we got to move prophetically when God gives us the unction. Amen. Praise God. Praise God. All right. So we've enjoyed ourselves in prayer, in encouragement, in declarations, in prophetic encouragement. Let's see what kind of word we can get in this morning as we press towards the end of this calendar year. For our year is spiritual year, and we have already started. Yes, Sister Althea, unlimited, unlimited, unlimited. Praise God. Hallelujah. Okay, so yesterday we dive into all of verse 7 and 8, Isaiah 61, 7 and 8, and a part of verse 9. Hallelujah. So we want to pick up at verse 9 again and transition in 10 minutes or so into verse 10. The word of God, Isaiah 61. Lord, take my tongue and teach me what to say. Grant me divine revelation that in the time that I have, I will be able to minister your peace, your joy, your revelation to your people, that lives might be transformed, that seed might be in the soil of our lives, and that we might bear fruit unto your glory. In Jesus' name, amen. So verse 9 says, our descendants will be known among the nations and their offsprings among the peoples. Our descendants will be known among the nations. Our descendants that carry the presence of God. Our descendants that are saved, sanctified, and Holy Ghost filled. Our descendants that are the righteous shall be envied by nations. Our descendants, come on, Billy Graham had a mother and a father. Come on. Hallelujah. All the great prophets and all the great men and women of God that have preached the gospel and have passed on, Smith Wigglesworth had a mother and father. And this promise was written before any man or woman that you can think of. Deborah in the Bible, Mary, Elizabeth. Come on, you could keep naming and naming and naming each and every one of them, those who went through good times and bad times. Abraham had a mother and a father. All of them had mothers and fathers. And this word was written for every mother and father, every son and daughter. Hear me carefully. Our descendants will be known among the nations, known for the presence of God, known for the power of God. I will not die until I have demonstrated what my son will be inspired by, what my daughter will be inspired by in God. You have to declare that. Do not die. Quenda, you will not die until your children have seen the glory of the Lord flow from you. Are you hearing me? The glory of the Lord until you have completed your spiritual task. You've done much in the world, in the natural, but until you have imparted to your children and your grandchildren that which will cause them to be known in the nations, you cannot die. Don't, as we say in Jamaican parlance, don't bother, don't do nothing now because you don't want to die, you know. In other words, translated, please, not because I've said this, you're now going to not do anything to impart into your children so you can live longer. That is a surefire way to shorten your life, not to lengthen it. Come on. But I'm just saying to you, we are staying positive and we are being encouraged. Do not delay imparting, speaking into, prophesying to your children who they are and who they should be in God, that they might be known in the nations. I am known in many nations now, maybe not by many, many people, but the nations that we broadcast our devotion to, people in those nations know me now. Why? Because my grandmother, 40 years ago, 45 years ago, prayed for me and believed the word of God. Pray for your children. Believe the word of God and it will come to pass. Mm-hmm. Amen. Praise God. And so I declare that Athena Alicia Clark will be known across nations for the excellency of spirit, the excellence of God. Darian Benjamin Wade will be known. Come on, you got to choose your own children. I don't know all your children's names. You got to declare your children and your grandchildren. Call them by name. Declare that they shall be known across nations. They shall be known across the world. Double shall be their portion from God, even as they have received double from Satan. We cancel every double curses and we release double blessing upon our families and upon our children in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. The Bible says our offspring shall be known among the peoples. Our offspring, my son, shall be a preacher of the gospel of Jesus Christ. He shall declare and decree. He shall heal the sick. He shall cast out devils. He shall speak with new tongues. Come on, glory to God. My daughter shall be a prophetess. She shall prophesy, thus saith the Lord, with forensic accuracy in the name of Jesus Christ. She shall get phone calls from presidents and prime ministers asking her, what is God saying? She shall be like Deborah times two. She shall be like Deborah on steroids. She shall be like Deborah 1201. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. It says, all who see them will acknowledge that they are a people the Lord has blessed. All who see our children shall acknowledge and say, these are people that the Lord has blessed. These are children that the Lord has blessed. These are the seed, the offspring of the righteous in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. Come on. If wicked people begin to see your children and declare that they are definitely the seed of the righteous, definitely people that God has blessed, then you would have done an amazing job by the Holy Spirit. Amen. Mm-hmm. Hallelujah. That's verse 9. Just one, a little part of verse 10. And we'll pick up again tomorrow because we're finishing this before the year ends. And we only have two more verses to go. Hallelujah. So that's verse 9. Hallelujah. They are a people the Lord has blessed. We are blessed and highly favored. Our children are blessed and highly favored in the name of Jesus Christ. And it says, God said, I delight greatly in the Lord. Come on. Hallelujah. I delight greatly in the Lord. My soul rejoices in my God. Come on. Hallelujah. So God is saying to us this morning, no matter what you're going through, your words must be, I delight greatly in the Lord. David said, why are you downcast, O my soul? Hope thou in God. Come on, glory to God. As we walk through the valley of the shadow of death, we do what? Hope thou in God. For the God who promises and cannot lie says that he will never leave us or forsake us. Says that his plans or his thoughts towards us are good and not evil, to give us a hope and a future to meet his expected end for us. His expected end is not for us to die in a ditch, to die like a B-I-T-C. You know it. Yeah. No, but to live, to prosper, to excel, to exceed expectations, to impact, to tear down and to build up. Come on, glory to God. To be mighty through him to the pulling down of every strongholds, to tread upon serpents and scorpions, to stand like Superman in a movie, hand on hip, ready to bust Satan's lip. Hey, glory, to take a sip of the cup of victory. Hey, bless God. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. So we're going to stop there. We're going to pick up again tomorrow from verse 10 and go into it some more and see the encouragement of the Lord. I hope that you were blessed this morning by what the Lord had to do by the prophetic prayers, and that your life feels better and different, that the sick feels healed. Come on, that the downcast feel like they are the head and no longer the tail. Come on, that the poor feel rich and that the weak feel strong by the presence and the spirit of the living God. We give God all glory, honor, and praise. Father, we thank you this morning for your time with us. We thank you that you have touched every life. You have touched every home. You have touched every family that is represented across these medium that have been established to carry your word to the ends of the earth. Lord God Almighty, may your soul searching eyes search the souls of every person that is on here this morning and every household. May salvation be their portion. God, may you convict and convert in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. And we thank you, Lord, that your will and your will only be done in Jesus' name. Amen and amen. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. I'm going to ask you as well, people of God, I am believing God for a miraculous move in your households, that even if your children, your spouse, members of your household are not directly paying attention, that if you are playing this devotion in the house and it is permeating the atmosphere and going into your children's room, into your spouse's ear, into any family member that is in the house ear, and they are hearing it, and they are not saved, they will begin to talk to you about Jesus and want to get saved. I want to get some testimonies. I am believing God that even though you are far and you will go to other churches, that's fine. All we want is to expand the kingdom. That's the ministry, the mandate of this ministry, to expand the kingdom. But I would love to be encouraged that persons have shifted their mindset and want to accept Jesus Christ because of what you have demonstrated in devotional time each day in the name of Jesus. We have to believe God for miracles that we didn't expect. Amen. So you are the one that is focused on the devotion and enjoying what's going on, but it is permeating the atmosphere in your house, and salvation can still come by just that reaching of God's people. Amen. Praise God. Praise God. So grab your communion. Grab your communion. It's communion time. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Bless God. Praise God. From whom all blessings flow. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Father, in the mighty name of the Lord Jesus Christ of Nazareth, we thank you for this morning. Thank you for the seed of righteousness that you have made us. Thank you for the places where you will cause us to sow that seed. And thank you for the harvest that will come forth from our lives and in our lives, so that our families, our communities, and our nations can truly be blessed from our time here on earth, in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Lord, as we have asked of you to manifest in and through us, we ask, O great and sovereign God, that you will manifest in these emblems as your body and as your blood. Strengthen, heal, deliver, set free, solidify, renew the covenant that you made with us, as we renew our acceptance of that covenant this morning with you by eating your body and drinking your blood. Father, we do not wish to eat of your body and drink of your blood unworthily. So we ask humbly that you will search us even now. Search our thoughts, search our words, search our actions. See if there be any open portal any portal that the enemy comes in and creates havoc in our righteousness. Cleanse and purify, sanctify and clean up this vessel so that we can truly be worthy to eat of your body and drink of your blood. In Jesus' name, amen. And so as the Lord Jesus Christ took the bread, he blessed it and broke it. He gave it to the disciples and he said, "Eat, this is my body broken for you. As often as you eat of it, you do it in remembrance of me." Eat ye all of it in faith. In Jesus' name. Hallelujah. And likewise, he took the cup, he blessed it and took a sup, and he said, "Drink, this is my blood, the blood of the new covenant. As often as you drink of it, you do it in remembrance of me. Drink ye all of it in faith, in Jesus' name." Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Guys, remember to be in prayer in a very sincere way for the nations of the world, in particular those that are under the bondage of this new strain of the COVID-19. Men ought always to pray and not to faint. No one deserves to go through the symptoms and the process of COVID-19, even the most evil of persons. We were once evil. So were we once. And God didn't give us the full measure of the punishment that we deserved. He showed us mercy. And so now we should show others mercy by interceding for them so that God can come to their rescue in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. Amen. So that's what we're doing. We're doing good this month. Hallelujah. Leading into the new year, we're doing all that God would want us to do and to be for his good pleasure. Remember to bless someone, encourage someone. Don't feel that you can't. Just do it. Do it scared, but do it. Do it afraid, but do it. Do it apprehensively, but do it. Come on, just do it. And as you do it, you will get through it. Amen. Praise God, from whom all blessings flow. Thank you so much for joining us on Facebook, on Instagram, on Arrows Internet Radio, and on YouTube. It's been an awesome morning. And God is faithful. Have a great, great day. May the Lord bless you and keep you. May the Lord make his face to shine upon you and be gracious unto you. May the Lord lift up the light of his countenance upon you and give you his peace. In the name of Jesus Christ. Go forth, family, and have an amazing day God's way. For our God has already shaken everything that is evil out of your day his way. In Jesus' name. Remember, Jesus love you, and we love the whole of honor too, from the weird household to every other household. Hey, make sure you're not cold, because Jesus have your soul. Amen. Bless you guys. Have a great day. Bye. Hallelujah to our King.